Hey, and welcome back. Today I'm going to talk a little bit about the modifications that I've done to my downhill bike. A lot of people ask me what I've done and whether I'm happy with the new parts that I've put on it. The bike that I started with is a 2015 Giant Glory team bike. It's a fantastic platform. It comes with RockShox Boxer team forks, which have the Charger damper, RockShox R2C rear shock. It has a Guide RSC brakes, DT Swiss EX471 wheels, X01 cranks and drivetrain. It's a very, very well sorted bike. What I wanted to do is make it a little bit more mine, add a bit of color and a little bit of functionality. So the first thing that went is it had a rear spring that was a 550 pounder, which was way too big for me. It's meant for heavy riders or people doing huge drops and hunks, which I don't do. So I went with a 400 pound spring because it really made it a very plush bike, and it's beautiful on the kind of techie fast trails that I really enjoy. The second thing I did was I put a Spank Spike VibroCore handlebar on it. Now, what VibroCore does is that it has this foam stuff on the inside that's supposed to dampen vibrations on long descents. And I have to say, a lot of people doubt it. I notice it. It's not a huge difference, but it's enough to notice it, especially when you're doing lap after lap after lap in the park. So I paid about $80 Canadian for it. It added a bit of color, and it makes my ride a little bit more comfortable, my arms and my hands a little bit less tired and numb at the end of the day. Money well spent. The second thing I did was I put a Spank Director stem on it, simply because it looks good. I wanted to match the handlebar. I really like Spank stuff. It's beautifully designed. It's really well made. It's one of the few stems that still comes with a top cap. So it just kind of made the cockpit of the bike look a little bit better. No regrets whatsoever. Zero performance advantages. It just looks cool, and it's money well spent. Other than that, I've put new pedals on it. I went with New Proof Horizons. I'm not crazy about them, but I'm not regretting them either. They were about $100 Canadian, which makes them more budget friendly than a lot of other pedals. They've lasted me well. I've still got all the pins. I've got no issues with the bushings after a season, but they're not the grippiest. I think my DMR V12s that I used to have held my feet in place a little bit better. They're not bad. They're just not quite as great as I was hoping they would be. Again, for $100, they're a good pedal. Next, I'll probably go with DMR Vaults or something like that. Not regretting them, but not crazy about them either. What I am crazy about, however, are my red valve caps. They cost me $1 from eBay, and I mean, if your budget allows it, splurge for it. It makes a big difference. The other thing that I did with it was I put little crank booties on it, and I do this to all of my bikes. They're made by Race Face. They can be color matched to your bike. They're made specifically for certain cranks. They're an extremely good fit, and it just cuts down on the anxiety when you strike a crank on a rock or something. I hate that sound, and I hate knowing that I just did some damage that can never be undone. For $12 or $13 that I paid for it, it's money well spent. It's peace of mind, looks good, performs well, no issues whatsoever. Finally, I put some Maxxis Assegai tires on it. These again make a big difference on the trail. They grip really well. They're fantastic on both dry and wet. They've served me really well. I went with the downhill casing and 2.5 inch on a 27.5 inch wheel. I have a season on them, and they've still got tons of tread. So they'll probably last me about two seasons, which is fantastic out of a set of tires for a downhill bike. And I put some SRAM metallic brake pads on it, because metallic is a way to go for downhill bikes. Again, $50, and I know that I've got a really good setup for my brakes that won't let me down. I've done lap after lap after lap, especially if you go to Mount Washington. There's not a lot of time between laps, because there's no lineup for the lifts. So it's really important that your brakes stay as cool as possible. I've had zero issues with them, so I'm really happy with it. Overall, I spent a little bit of money. It looks a little bit better than it did from the factory. It was just all black and dark blue. I wanted to liven it up a little bit, and they're a little bit of I've gotten a little bit of performance gains out of them as well. Going forward, the only other thing I'm going to do is I'll probably swap the pedals over to DMRs whenever these wear out. I'm happy with them. I'm happy enough with them to not be wanting to change them right away. I also put a new seat post on it because I absolutely hate the giant one, the one that has two bolts on either side and it's got a bunch of moving parts, and to line it up to the exact angle you want was an absolute nightmare. I got a cheap one from Raceface. I think I paid about $33 for it, and it's held my seat in place, and that's all I want out of a seat post. No other issues with it. Other than that, I've had no problems with the bike, and it's been a really trusty, fun bike. I think I'm done modifying it for the most part. Maybe a bit bigger brake in the back. It's only got 180. Might step up to 200 next season. Other than that, it's a well-sorted bike that's been both reliable and it gets a lot of compliments on the mound. So what more could you want? That's it for me for today. I'm going to do another video like this for my trail bike as well. Let you guys in on what parts I've swapped and what I think of them. And that's about it. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, any comments, leave them in the comment section, and happy trails.